technology we have used and we could able to conduct our regular businesses, and we could able to run our organization by using the technology. Because the technology which is so useful are also at the same time is being misused by the people. Misused in the terms of the, we can't say that a particular age group is being misused, but every human being is being influenced by the social media, and their lifestyle is completely changed. We all have observed, if in a family there are 4 to 5 members in a family, all will be sitting on the dining table for having a lunch or the dinner, and but everybody while having the lunch, they don't, instead of speaking to each other, discussing with each other, everybody will be looking at the phone and opening the WhatsApp groups or whatnot. So they don't even care a person who is sitting opposite to you, and they don't even care what food they are taking, but their focus is on the mobile. And also, if somebody is called for a meeting, and when the meeting is going on, most of the attendees of the meeting, instead of listening to the speaker, they will be engaged in the operation of the their smartphones. So this is the kind of the lifestyle which has been changed because of the technology, and this is giving a negative effect. As per my information, when I interact with many students as well as many institutions, the complete learning system of the students has influenced the social media, because now the people are engaged in social media, and particularly in the youth, they are engaged in a lot of phone medias and a lot of other games which are disturbing their at the very early age, and also there are some games where the people are committing suicide.
Oh, okay. So
recently one of my member has brought a child to my office, so that person has become so abusive that if anybody tried to stop him from using the phone or to stopping him from using the games, he will be attacking them because whatever the things he has nearby, whatever the things he has nearby, he will be attacking them brutally. So menace which is being created by the social media. So it is the responsibility of all of us to give a proper proper guidance for the children how to use the social media right from the early age. So that only is going to cure this problem which is being created by the advancement of the social media. Another thing, what we have seen is that a lot of fake news is being circulated on the social media. You know that many social media many politicians are using, media people are using. So this media is a positive attitude among the citizens. It is also creating a negative attitude and also creating a vengeance against each other communities, each other religions, and whatnot. So it is the responsibility of every citizen. Before transmitting one message which I have received, I should check whether it is a genuine news or not. Many things which whatever we receive, we got used for transferring it to other friends. Just like a postman who doesn't even check what is the content in it. His job is to go and deliver it to the addressee. Similarly, we are all not applying our minds to the subject what we received in various sources, and we don't check the authenticity of that, and we don't think of the impact which is going to create by transforming the information to others. We are blindly passing it on to many people who are known to us. So as a responsible citizen, we must ensure before passing on that particular message which have been received by us to others, we have to see the genuineness, and we have to think of the impact which it is going to create on the minds of the others. Accordingly, the even the media people, they're also using it in a way according to their own agendas. The every media, unfortunately, in this country, everybody has their own agendas. Everybody has their own political affiliations. Everybody has their commercial interest. So all these things are also, apart from transmitting through their own media, they're also transmitting through the social medias. Now we have seen so many political parties are socially active. Many politicians, they have employed or engaged many PR agencies to promote their ideology as well as their branding, and also attacking the other people, other opposition political parties and their leaders. So all these are making us a lot of mess, and every day the persons, because during COVID time we have seen a lot of pollution has been decreased in various cities, including Delhi, because a lot of pollution has been controlled because the people were not moving on the streets, and because we are not emitting any smoke or any pollution through using of our vehicles. So, but during the COVID, social media has acted like anything. Because of social media, the mindset of the people within the family has changed. And as far as my knowledge goes, I have come across many complaints because of this social media. The domestic abuse has increased. I have instances where the parents started scolding children, and children started scolding parents, and there were a lot of fighting between among themselves for using the phone, for not using the phone. All such things have been happened. So this is the havoc which is being created by the social media, and this suppose if it is not controlled from right from now, I think in future it will be very difficult, because as we see in the most developed countries, their lifestyle, how they have changed, because they have been using earlier than us, and now the impact which has been created on the minds of the people of those countries, because India is a very traditional country, and Indian culture is something different from the other parts of the world. And now this social media is disturbing our tradition and our culture and our habits and the relations between the family and the citizens. So this has to be curbed by all of us, particularly the role of Hyderabad is in that. For that, we need to chalk out a program, and we need to organize effective use, because through this media, we can also create a positive things. So those positive things while creating, because nowadays, even the classes are being conducted through the web technologies, and so many things are happening through web. In similar way, we should also make the short films, the negative impact of the social media on the citizens, to create awareness among the youth right from the younger age. So all these things we need to plan. For that, even the government has to take the initiative, because otherwise we are going to pay the heavy price in future for the growth of our nation. And the effect on our tradition and culture. So with these views, I congratulate the PRCI for organizing this seminar, and I wish that these programs have to be taken up in a larger way, involving the many people in the process. Thank you very much.
Yeah, over to Shakil.
Shakil ji, unmute yourself, please.
Shakil bhai, unmute.
Yes. Thank you, dear friend Ravi ji, for sharing your thoughts with us. Your viewpoints are excellent and well received. It is a fact, communication basically isn't in just terms of the media or news. It is also in terms of how we communicate with each other, because ultimately that is what impacts the society. And we as public relation professionals are well versed with how we think, how we carry the things around with us. It is a fact. The very nature of how technology works inhibits personal communication. Feelings and emotions are the biggest losers in this entire game. Unfortunately, of late, what has happened is the wave of new media, the digital media, has overtaken the conservative print and electronic media. It is said well that the old always remains the gold, but right now the impact of digital media is huge on the society. If we have a look at the reports yesterday in the newspapers, there was an issue at the Supreme Court wherein some petitioner went complaining against the fake news being spread by the mainstream media, and the government, union government, took the right viewpoint, saying that, well, you can come to the mainstream media because they are identified, they are known. Why don't you first have a look at all that crass in terms of digital media, which doesn't have censorship, which doesn't have identity, which doesn't have a source who can be curbed. It needs a lot of efforts to reach out to one who's spreading the fake news. Even the union government has accepted the fact that communication needs to be assimilated in a more proper way. On an average, they say, at present, we are spending about 4 to 5 hours on the digital media. To what extent that enables us, we are not sure. But the fact is, when you have a look at the other side of it, the news channels on the YouTube are actually able to get us news more faster, more authentic, in several cases, than the mainstream media itself. That is why people are, a bit habituated to reaching out to their favorite YouTube news channels. So you can't even, shirk away that the YouTube channels are also here to stay. Before I proceed to my next speaker, I would just like to, briefly introduce him. He is another of my dear friend, Lakshmikant Jonnalagadda. He is the managing director for WinNerve Project Management Institute. He is also a chief mentor for Vedika Speaking Society. By that, probably you can understand that he is into a lot of activities concerning the youth in particular. He has been involved in technology strategy, resource acquisition, risk management, rental management. He is a certified project manager with proven skills in business development and handling several management programs. He has met good targets with regard to undertaking interpersonal skill education at different levels. And friends, to share with you, he has left a very lucrative profession in the Western countries to come over to India and share his viewpoints and thoughts with us all. I would request Sri Lakshmikant Jonnalagadda garu to please share his viewpoint, keeping the fact in view that public relations professionals are facing a huge dilemma with regard to how they can carry on with utilizing the digital media the right way so that communication remains on the right track. Over to you, Lakshmikant Jonnalagadda garu. Thank you. Lakshmikant Jonnalagadda garu, please.
Okay. Thank you very much, Shakil Ahmed garu. That's a very interesting introduction of me. I mean, I'm very humbled by your introduction.
I told it in very brief, sir. Otherwise, it is very elaborate.
I'm really glad to be here speaking alongside Vinay Kumar Garu, Ravi Kumar Garu, the speaker who spoke before me. And this evening's topic is very intriguing and very important as well. And as we all know, communication, I would put it in a simple way, communication is king. You know, usually people might say currency is king or technology is king. I would say communication is king, because if we are good at communication, then you know, there are many things that we can do. There are many ways we can overcome hurdles, and there are many things we can achieve. Let me look at this topic, when technology treads the wrong path in communication, from a couple of different perspectives. As Ravi Kumar Garu rightly mentioned, India and Indian culture are very unique from that we find in many of the Western countries. And the nucleus of Indian culture obviously is family. There is no denying the fact. Of course, there have been many misgivings on that front over the past couple of decades, that you know, the family values are going down, degrading and all. But still, even as of today, womb to tomb, Indian man or woman is mostly dictated by whatever happens in the family in a major way. So that is understood here. And as Ravi Kumar Garu also rightly pointed out, the media, the explosion of digital media, social media, and all the tools that are being made available to everyone, and youth in particular, is it a boon or a bane, you know? So let us look at it from the perspective of the implementation, how it is being implemented, how it is being used. When we see, since the topic is the wrong path being tread by technology in communication, let us look at the wrong side of technology in communication. If we look at the crimes being committed, the cyber crimes or any crimes for that matter, not just cyber crimes, or suicides that are being committed, and depression cases, anxiety cases, illnesses, or even if we look at education sector, the low grades that most students are getting. And who are the ones who will be deciding on whether it is a crime or not, whether it is a disease or not, whether the student is ranking low or not? So when we go to the keepers of these areas, the police, the psychiatrists, the doctors, the teachers, the first thing they will tell us is the negative impacts of technology on the people who are committing crimes, patients who are getting into depression, anxiety, and employees and other people who are developing all sorts of illnesses while using the technology. And then obviously the teachers complaining about the misuse, addiction, and abuse of technical tools by students of all different ages, and how it is adversely impacting students' communication skills, and then thereby degrading their grades. Any negative impact in the society, be in societal values, in social order, familial values, anything we see, anything that is happening in a negative way, when we look at the root cause of that, I think we are unfortunately finding a connection to technology and communication tools. Look at any case that is being cracked by the police. They are, you know, first of all, they are the first reaction is to find the cell phone of the culprit or the victim, or the laptops they use, or the of the culprits and victims. Why are they doing that? Because they understand the value of communication, especially the technical tools, the technology, the social media, the communication that happens between different people that are involved in these crimes. And they want to crack these cases based on the communication that happened between these people involved. So that goes to show how big a role, even without our acknowledgement, communication is taking daily lives. We may be using mobile phones inadvertently or unknowingly, just like that, but that is acting as a tracking device, for good or bad. So that is one way we can see that technology in communication, how it is being used in a negative way, and the kind of negative vibes it is spreading. And of course, you know, police and are also using the same technology to catch hold of the criminals and all. So let us put that aspect on one side. Now let's step back a little, and if we look at the human evolution, right from when man evolved, for many millennia, many hundreds of thousands of years, Homo sapiens, they did not, the evolution, the development did not happen very rapidly. The evolution started happening rapidly only when human beings started inventing tools, creating technologies and making tools, whether it be the age-old stone age, sharpening of the stones and creating stone tools, which helped the early humans in protecting themselves from wild animals, safeguarding themselves, cultivation. And then Iron Age, when we saw many, iron tools. And then to the latest modern age, when we see, internet, computers, smartphones and all. These are all technologies being developed, and technology is technology, tools are tools, they're just tools. The devil lies in how we use the technology, how we use those tools. See, for example, black powder invented in, I think the 9th century or so, was first invented for using medicine, as a medicine. But then they started using it after a couple of centuries, they started using it as gunpowder after they invented the gun. The same black powder which was used in medicine, they started using it in guns, and it's renamed as gunpowder. And we all know about Alfred Nobel, on whose name Nobel prizes are being given. He invented dynamite. And dynamite, it was actually invented. And when it was invented, it was used for many positive developments. It expedited mining. It expedited construction work. It expedited demolitions and all. But then we know how people started abusing dynamite. And that led Alfred Nobel to give away all his money, all his wealth, to establish a trust and announce Nobel Prize for Peace. So then, you know, when there was a lot of energy crisis, we know how scientists invented, you know, did atomic reactions, nuclear chain reactions. And as of today, more than the whole world, energy needs are being met by nuclear power stations. But we know how the US used the same technology to bomb Hiroshima and Nagasaki, the Japanese cities. And then the internet. All these technologies, they started off to expedite human development, to bring some positive changes to humanity. And pretty much we have been using them in similar fashion. But come this social media, this the smartphones, the camera phones, the video phones, and then the explosion of internet. We see many people using these to provide themselves with education, connecting people far off, who are far off and who could not otherwise see each other or meet each other. So there are a lot of positive aspects, but since today's topic is on the negative aspects of technology in communication, let me just say this. Tools are just tools. Technology is just technology. But it is the human being and intention of the human being to use those same technology and tools either in positive way or negative way. And unfortunately, off late, we have been seeing more and more negative use of technology, especially in communication, because as I said earlier, communication is king, and technology is making communication possible, cheaper, faster. Now, how do we address this? When we look at all these tools, since I am listed as an expert on this, let me bring in how time as a resource, as a tool, plugs in to the technology and communication, so that we may find a way of addressing this menace of technology treading negative paths in communication. So again, you know, tools when used well help our development, help our progress. But what is happening is people ignoring or unable to understand the significance of time as a resource, time as a resource. We need to emphasize that time is life and life is time, and time should be treated as any other resource out there, but only time is invaluable. We can neither create it nor borrow it. So to make the best use of any other tools or resources or skills, we need to bring in a culture of understanding the value of time and
తిరుమల పాయ హోస్ట్ వచ్చింది చూడు
I think there is a problem.
Zinak Fuji.
Jacob, please check. There is some change in the host.
Failure on my part.
No failure here. These things are happen. You know, we are into virtual meetings. And everyone, you know, understands that virtual is just virtual. It isn't personal.
Okay.
Sorry about that. I think
my laptop connection somehow dropped.
Yeah, please.
So I would like to bring in this aspect of understanding the value of time and applying that understanding in using the tools and technology in better communicating with everyone. For that, I think we really need to make sure our parents, teachers, and elders need to inculcate the appreciation for time and also promote safe use of technology in communication, because as we said, communication is king. And so that young people do not fall prey to...
Is it recording or not?
The impulsivity, narcissism, and aggression that are driving youth today by abusing all these internet and technical tools in communication, and which are actually also unfortunately raising the suicide rates, depression levels, and all kinds of emotional stress that is being experienced by not just youth, actually even adults in this fast-paced world. So we really need to understand how to use and not misuse or abuse these technical tools in communication, the social media, Facebook, Twitter, and gain in emotional intelligence. So we understand that fine line between use and abuse, use and addiction. And I think if we can do that, the value of time, understanding the difference between use, misuse, and abuse, and increase our emotional intelligence, will be developing faster in a positive sense. So those are the three things I wanted to touch upon today in my talk. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lakshmikant Garu. Jacob, I take the mic. Jacob, are you there?
Yeah, please continue, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Lakshmikant Garu. You have dwelt on very appreciable points. Down the line, it very well looks like communication is indispensable. Technology for communication is, again, indispensable. Incidentally, whatever you say when you speak of communication, PR professionals are indispensable. That is why they have to take the onus and the load for how communication remains within their profession and outside their profession. This is an unfortunate enigma that gets attached with PR professionals. They are, supposed to be performing dual-oriented tasks.
Right.
It is a fact that, for PR professionals, all the ills of the digital media have come up as a big challenge. Incidentally, it happens several times that, the PR professional is wanting to highlight a very factual position of his organization. And even before that happens, there would be, some channels which would be coming out with unsubstantiated news, carrying a different picture of, the story from the organization. And by the time the factual information comes from the PR person, damage is already done in terms of the fake or the news not based on facts that is already spread, jumping the gun. Incidentally, media has been a bit irresponsible to the extent that several times, even in case of the deaths of eminent personalities, they have carried the news that they are no more, whereas the fact was otherwise. Very recently also these things have happened. Nothing much to elaborate. Going further on it is one very, very important aspect of communication, which is facing a thorough, I would say, postmortem in the transparent way. That is, I mean it in terms of the cyber crimes. before we go up to this subject, I would make a special request to the most accomplished of the PR professionals in the country, Sri Jairam Ji sir, to please share his thoughts. Please, sir, Jairam Ji sir, I would want you to speak a few words as to how communication, if it treads the wrong path, can be disastrous. Jairam Ji sir, please.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank
good you, sir. Evening, everyone. I think it is better if I talk at the fag end. Let us hear the third speaker. Then we can talk in the last segment.
Fine, sir. No
it problem. Is better. Yeah, please.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank no you. Problem, sir. No problem, sir. Well, friends, like how I have told you, we are coming into, you know, one very specific aspect of communication related to the rise in crimes on the digital avenues. And crimes are not just associated with the society. They have got their takeoff even with regard to the PR professionals and their jobs. It is a fact. PR professionals are not just contracted, you know, to highlight the company's image. They are also contracted in terms of, you know, ensuring that the image rubs off on the business. The image rubs off on the marketing. It's basically a direct-to-consumer model. And internet and web technology are the additional factors of PR, which disseminate information. When that happens, several times the competitiveness, the aggressiveness in the market leads to situations where cyber crime stalks organizations in terms of infringing or rather, you know, committing theft of data. And theft of data is like, you know, a virtual gold mine landing into wrong hands to convey a wrong image. That is where PR gets again associated with cyber crimes. Cybercrime, like you all know, has got many a facet associated with it. It is in terms of, you know, crime related to data, crime related to fake news, crime related to stealing information on organization, intellectual property, a lot of things. It is a fact. Right now, no organization can say it is bulletproof when it comes to their data security. I would like to introduce a very young gentleman who is also one of the topmost hackers in the country, Sri Hari Krishna Valugonda, to the audience. A youngster with 10 years of experience in various dimensions, including in information security management. He has been a security analyst. He has been a certified ethical hacker. He holds a host lot of licenses. He has been the recipient of various honors and awards, and is listed in the Hall of Fame in two different very well-known organizations. He has been working as a lead security consultant for EPAM. He loves to crack puzzles and create new ones. He is a leader for Null Hyderabad Information Security Open Group. This group conducts info security seminars open for all on monthly basis. One of his major achievements was in 2013 when he got selected for Global Cyber Olympics from Asia, representing India for World Final Hacking Competition held at USA. I welcome Sri Hari Krishna Valugonda to share his thoughts, particularly in relation to how it can be detrimental to communications, to media, and to the interests of the public relations professionals too. Welcome, Hari Krishna Garu.
Thank you. Thank you, Shakil ji. Let me start with the standard COVID webinars, what we do. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
yes, we can.
Great. So I have a short presentation. When I received this request for presentation, I was unsure, I should say, what should I talk on, how communication goes bad in security world or a cyber crime world. So I've created a quick PPT. I'll not take much of time. I'm sure I'll keep value of everybody's time here. I'll start sharing the screen. Shakil ji, can you give me permission to share screen?
Please, Jacob. Please, sir. Jacob, My colleague Jacob would be taking care of it. Jacob, request to please ensure that he shared the screen.
What's his name?
Hari Krishna Valugunda.
Yes. 1 minute.
Yes, yes.
He's listed as Hari V.
Yeah.
Yes.
Hari V.
Yes.
Okay.
Surnames are bigger. So.
And incidentally, Hari Garu, right at this moment, you know, when I'm accessing my computer, I have got a system alert which says you are being tracked. 15 tracking cookies on your PC.
Maybe Hari Garu is tracking you.
No.
Yeah. So I've given you co-host, sir.
Yeah,
thank you.
Okay. I hope you can see my screen now.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Great. I would not brag about myself. Thanks for Shakilji, which he did. But I would say I'm a qualified person to present this. That's what I can request you. And what I do, I eat, drink, sleep, security. This is what I do in day in, day out life. Last 12 years, I'm doing this stuff. So when I go to some place, even in a temple or any other places, I always see what are the loopholes. So that's how the mindset has been modified. So human evolution, we need to understand this is how the human evolution happened. The last two parts on the right hand side, now going back to mobile communication. So without internet, you may not stay at home in not more than an hour or so. So we become I famously say we are no more humans, we are robots now. We have IDs, right? Nobody's going to ask you what's your name. Instead, they ask you, what's your email ID? What's your contact? blah, blah, blah. So that's a fascinating story, what we have. We forgot that we are by names, not by IDs, but we did not understand when it took over altogether. Like somebody is talking about Twitter handle, somebody is talking about Facebook handle, nobody asks you what is your real names. So let's quickly jump in. So when I thought, what will I present? Then I've decided to in line with the theme. So I came up with this idea called security versus safety, right? Most of people think this are same, but not. So security is it's everybody's responsibility, as I'm sure everybody would heard these lines and everybody will be doing this. Security is everybody's responsibility. Safety is the way you behave to protect the assets or threats from the risks. So let's only discuss today about safety. So Ravi sir explained about an excellent point where people are using cell phones, iPads on a dining table, and they're on internet all around. And Lakshmikanthji also said about how well we can use technologies. Now I'll add one more word called how secure we can use technologies. Because let assume if your company holds a customer data, and if your company website goes wrong, so it's going to be a challenge to face the customer, because you cannot save your own data. How can you save customer data? So it is something like it's important to be secure, and it is important to be safe for online technologies, as Lakshmikanthji was saying, like Twitter, Facebook, and we become more of technology people now, right? So I will discuss three basic attacks which are highly increasing in last 6 months during COVID time. Let's quickly jump in. So phishing and vishing, I am sure most of you are aware of phishing, the malicious links which comes up, you click and you give your data and people steal your money or passwords or accounts. But recent times, the vishing has been more popularly gaining the attention, right? Vishing is nothing but you get a call saying that, do you need a loan? It's not that, that's not a vishing. But if somebody is calling you, asking your person details or impersonating something, like example, a person may call you and say he's from certain bank, and say your due, your EMI or your payment is due to particular dates, and he's going to send you a link. So Wishing is convincing the target or impersonating particular group of companies or a person or an individual and catching hold of the targets. So we'll see how it happens also. So I'm sure by this time you have already done your exercises on phishing. A lot of companies are dealing with phishing. They send phishing links to the employees. If you click that link, they're going to give you training on cybersecurity again, this awareness. So I'm not emphasizing on phishing because I assume everybody knows that. So the phishing, which is picking up recent times, we'll discuss that. So how this phishing happens? Phishing's it's again a targeted attack for some time, again a specific or random attack. So like you may get a number, you call 100 people and you find 10 victims. So most probably the phishing works on emails and phishing works on calls, phone calls. So attacker, what I mean by attacker here is the person who is going to do this phishing will find you details about a particular target. Example, me, my name, Hari. So he can find all the information available on social media. So like example, my full name, my family details, employer details, possibly your pet names or pets names, possibly your maid name also. So I'm not sure, but a lot of people also write about their maids on the social media. That's a surprising fact. And they already know about your hobbies, the favorites, like you which car you like, or which like Bollywood actor you follow, blah, blah, blah. So these all the data they collect to create an attack called phishing. So they call you up. So what kind of possible attacks we have? Again, there is huge list of possibilities in phishing. I wrote few, not all. Like they pretend to be calling, like they're calling from bank, asking for your PAN card or date of birth or any secret questions which they come up, right? So sometimes you get a call like income tax or Paytm. I'm not taking any brand name here. It could be anything or any other. So again, sometimes the call from recruiting consulting, and sometimes it may be you won a lottery. I think everybody know about famous Nigerian lottery and the scam which happened. So moving next, how do you prevent this all? So don't trust unknown phone calls or identity of person claims. If you get a call saying that, example, let's say ICICI Bank get a call saying that I'm calling from ICICI Bank, and if somebody is saying that he is a representative of ICICI Bank, you should verify whether it's a legitimate call or not. So how do you do that? Do you ask his ID card? How do you validate if he's a bank personnel or not? It's the same method what they do. Ask them to give us the last transaction what we made. It's equal opportunity. You can ask this question. Yeah, again, keep an eye on words. Again, the calls are not educated calls. So whenever you get a calls, remember that they use a lot of vague terminologies, like we are talking behalf of some X company, our parent company is different, and there is emergency, urgency, where you need to pay, you need to click the link for within 2 days, or you get your account will be blocked. So a lot of vague statements. There will be nothing like a generic 2 days or 2 weeks or 1 week. Any company or any legitimate call will send you an email, send you a text message, but not the links. Okay, more importantly, no company or bank will ask you for OTP, one-time password. No company under the sky will do that. So if somebody is calling you on a phishing call saying that we have sent you in a 4-digit number, 6-digit number, don't give it to anyone. So again, most of time in phishing, the act of urgency is the key, right? We are in rush to solve the problem. We want to solve it right this minute. We don't want to get into next problematic statement. So that's how. So don't be in rush or commit or act. The best statement I give is ignorance is bliss, right? If you get a call, ignore, keep calm. If it is a legitimate call, they would come back again with a proper channel. So moving next, if somebody would ask me, like, do we get a lot of social media, like, can attacker get all the information on social media? Yes. Most of the time, yes. Here are a few examples. On the left-hand side, you can see somebody post a debit card of Chase Bank along with the screen. On right-hand side, I'm just trying to give an example, Wi-Fi, SSID named as virus attack. Okay, moving next, let's discuss a very common topic called passwords. So I've tried to put some basic passwords, Apple $123, 123456789090, QWERTY. I'm sure most of you, your Wi-Fi passwords are your mobile numbers. So easy to remember. So let's discuss about the password. Okay, my question for everyone, what is your password? Somebody want to answer it? Okay, that's good. So we should not answer. It's a sensitive information. Okay, I over the period of time, I understand the passwords are different category. I wrote few of them, right? It's like one God. One God, I mean by saying it is one password for all. So the users use single password across internet. It could be Twitter, it could be Facebook, your office, professional mails, banking account or anything. It's one password, standard alphanumeric 8 characters, standard password. And another category of people use biryani, this example. What I'm trying to put is like, if you notice that is a chicken biryani and mutton biryani, it is low level example, I agree, but I could not find easiest way to write that. So what I mean by that, if somebody is using Gmail, so their password would be standard, adding Gmail at the end. If somebody is using Facebook, so their password would be ending with the Facebook. Example, like say Apple $123 Gmail, Apple $123 Facebook. So this is also one single password, but the prefix and suffix will change based on the service provider. And somebody seasons, right? Seasons, say they like seasons, like they write winter, summer, spring, kind of, right? October 8, winter kind of stuff. And few other people love themselves, like they write their date of birth, phone number, car or kids. So this is type of passwords what we have. So this is small, is your password secure enough is one small topic I want to discuss here. Over the period of time, I cracked a lot of passwords. I noticed a different patterns. People try to reuse same password across all the social media network. So these are the patterns I tried to put in. In pattern one, you can see the passwords are shuffling. In pattern two, the passwords are based on the service providers. In pattern three, it's a sample passwords. But the funniest part was boss barking at October 2012. This was something when I cracked this password, I was laughing out loud. So, if you ask me what's a better way to save a password, it's always go back to old traditional way. So I understand it's a big debatable topic, like you have number of apps, number of service providers, number of services on your phone, on websites, how do you keep track of them? So it's not easy, right? You can use a password manager like the open source password management tools, which is handy, or you can write a complex password, write down in Excel or write down somewhere in your notebook if you are worried that somebody can share your screens or your laptops. So just for a simple case, what I want to try to understand, like somebody say my password is 8 characters long, alphanumeric and a special character. So this is, I want to give a number, like how a dictionary attack and brute force attack can crack it, right? It hardly takes 12 minutes if it is 8 characters and alphanumeric. And if it is only 8 characters, it's 2 hours. So if you're using a 4 characters, it is less than a second. So this is a number, just a stats which want to show, right? If you want to be more secure, use a complex password which have alphanumeric special characters and larger than or longer than 8 characters. I would rather recommend 10 at least. So any questions till now before we go there further? Okay, either I'm going fast or...
Please continue, sir.
Oh, sure. Yeah. Okay. So the other part I want to discuss, the third one and final one, which has a very huge rise in cyber crimes, is ransomware. So I'm sure you are already aware on the ransomware. Ransomware is a malicious software or a package or exe or executable, what I mean to say, is sent to you by an attacker. When you click this and install it, or click this and get auto installed, and your files will be encrypted, and then the attacker would send you a message to pay the ransom. So I picked the easiest pictures, like on left hand side, it is a movie from Taken, the ransom, like in the in this case, the hero has been demanded for ransom for kidnapping her daughter. On the right hand side, I just want to show the pictorial view, like now systems, right? Now, no, you don't need a malicious actor outside, it's online now. So it is like they put the gunpoint on your head for the ransom. So here are the ransomware sample screenshots, just for visualization prospect. So these are all possible cases where you can get the ransomware. Like if you see one of the attachments says scan_invoice, your order has been declined.zip, which is interesting, right? You will definitely open and unzip it and see it. So beware of this kind of attachments. So don'ts, I'll not explain do's, but again, majorly don'ts. Think twice before clicking any links. Either it could be on your social media or on your professional emails or personal emails. Don't open any attachments. If you are in dilemma, never open it. Or if you receive that from unknown prospect, unknown person, make sure you validate whether he's it's a right intention email or not. I would rather say, if doubt, leave it out from there. So, closing the topic with a lot of time when I do a session, like people ask, like, how do we avoid this kind of things majorly? Like, how do you create your social profiling separately for professional and personal? So a lot of time what we do is we subscribe most of the websites with our personal email address. So few people go one step ahead, they create one junk mail on Gmail or other service provider. So they will use the subscription, like you have a professional email or personal emails aside, and one temporary kind of email, which you subscribe to the PDFs or documents or readable things. So to avoid that, so here are a few tips I want to give, this kind of a takeaway for this session, right? There is something called disposable email addresses, which is Yopmail and MailDrop. These are the disposable email addresses where you don't need to sign up anything, right? If somebody is asking, please subscribe to get this PDF to read, so you can use them as the website, like Yopmail and MailDrop, which are disposable email addresses. I will show you in a minute how it works. So so this is Yopmail again. Technically, this site do not ask you a password or anything, but this is an email address which you can create anything. Let's say I want to create a Hari test. I can just say checkbox. I can see my email box is ready, and I can start using Hari test at Yopmail anywhere. So if you understand what I'm trying to say, now you have a valid email address. Now, if I have to sign up to any portal, which you don't want to give away your personal email addresses, you can use this kind of website. So normally you can see there could be email which, this is Hari test Yopmail. So you get a lot of emails from here. So you don't need to spam your personal email addresses for a temporary prospect. So moving back to on again, how do you now, emails are old things. Now they're asking OTPs, right? Now they ask OTP to enter to validate your phones and other things. There is one more site which you can use, which is called receive-sms-online.info, where this site will give you an online mobile number where you can use for OTP. So when you sign up for some website where you don't want to share your personal mobile number, you can use this kind of email addresses, and then you can receive the OTPs like what you're receiving here from here. So technically you save your privacy from there. So avoid as much as your personal and professional email addresses whenever possible and the phone numbers. So that's all I got. If you have any questions.
So thank you, Harigaru. Most importantly, questions aren't being asked by the PR professionals because they have become too immersed in the subject. They know pretty well, you know, they also need to handle their own websites, their email IDs, which several times carry a lot of professional information, and these inputs actually, you know, act to benefit our caliber, our strength. In fact, I would make a request to you, if possible, please share this PPT with me so that we again, you know, share it amongst the entire PRCA fraternity, because all said and done, PR professionals are going to be definitely benefited if they keep their mails, if they keep their organizational inputs secure. I would request you to please share this PPT with us. And second thing is, for PR professionals, this also, you know, is a very, very interesting assimilation with regard to the internal communications in the organization, which is another role for PR professionals. We are expected to, you know, inform, keep our people in the organization abreast, you know, on their own welfare. And probably these inputs from you are sure going to help the PR professionals plan their internal communication so that the organization and its workforce stands to gain. My request, please share the PPT.
Sure, Shakil. Thanks for the opportunity. Again, this is quite a basic things what I've tried to put in. It's quite important. Like, there is no such thing called hack the servers. I'll close with this line. Most of my friends ask, like, you being a hacker kind of stuff, can you hack somebody's password? There are a lot many requests I receive. So I'll give a small story, a minute story, where one of my friend asked me, like, can you hack my girlfriend's passwords, blah, blah, blah. And I said, it is not a possible case. So then he tried to reach online, search for how can I hack Gmail. Then he went through a lot of stuff. Again, he filled a lot of forms there. He also ultimately lost his own account. So it is always important, like, it's not like service provider will leak anything. It is we as a human being, safety is from our side. So we give away the data. We give away our passwords, not they.
Yes, yes, yes.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Harigaru. Thanks a lot. Dear friends, until now, we have been hearing, you know, all the perspectives with regard to communication, you know, when it treads the wrong track. Now, we are into something where technology has got something inbuilt, which is basically, I would say, you know, sort of a technology input that actually lancets into different, very, very sensitive, very critical situations wherein our thoughts do not match the words or the action. I'm speaking of how our smartphones are basically prone to typographical errors and the autocorrect inputs. To share with you, our poster banner of PRCI for this webinar had a typo. And I don't think any one of us, except for one or two persons, they could notice that, you know, there was a typo, and that was actually deliberate. We had done it. I would leave to, you know, my friends, you know, to have a look at it later.
Okay.
I would just like to introduce the final speaker for this day,
Padam.
Mr. Bhavneet Singh, who basically Jacob, I think you need to mute. Jacob, please mute. Please mute the others. I would like to introduce the fourth and the final speaker for the day, Mr. Bhavneet Singh. He basically comes from a journalism background. He has been with the Times of India as a correspondent. Then he has been on the prime time of Radio Mirchi, hosting different shows, and is a very, very well-known name. And the third and most interesting aspect of his multidimensional communication capabilities, why I call him a multitasker, is because with journalism, with being a RG, he is also one of the best known stand-up comedians who creates, I would say, happiness out of misery. Sometimes we tend to laugh at our own selves, and that is the best way we tend to relax. And he is quite an expert in doing that. Bhavneet writes at a silly and argumentative, because that is what makes us feel happy about. He was a part of the traveling comedian show, India's only comedy radio trip, which performed in 27 cities within 31 days. He has done over 60 corporate shows. Most importantly, he is a student who basically, you know, had his entire education until his PG from Hyderabad. His PG was from the Loyola Academy. That is why he is very loyal to the city of Hyderabad. I would invite Mr. Bhavneet to please share his inputs with regard to how things like autocorrect, typos can create situations. Yes, there was a situation where, you know, we type, are you sure you want to exit? And you said you want to exist. This is how things tend to take a turn. I invite Bhavneet to please come over. Thank you, Bhavneet.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Shakil sir. Thank you so much for having me. Firstly, I have to be very honest up front. I am really scared talking to all of you guys, because everyone before me was an expert in the field and I just make jokes. Okay, so I am little scared. So please don't judge me. Lenny sir, please don't look at me like that. I am little scared of you. Okay, I hope I can make you laugh. Okay, if I can make Lenny sir laugh.
You're a multi-skilled communicator, and that is very important for PR professionals also. We need to sometimes get out of, you know, very critical situations, and this helps.
Right. No, it's this is also a very important moment for me being a part of this webinar. It's because I was on the other side of the spectrum. I was a reporter with the Times of India, and I remember going to Shakil sir, and I remember going to Michael sir, and I was like, sir, please give me stories. And now it's very nice that they call me back, you know, because before this, I was the one, sir, please story, sir. This is the first time Shakil sir actually called me back. And it's like, you know what, I need your help. So it felt really nice. It's like an arc in my story has completed. But today's topic is about how technology, how these goof ups in technology can cost us a lot, right? And I know what you guys must be wondering. A lot of you are wondering that why is a person who is probably half my age telling me something, right? It is an instinct. Like if someone who's half my age tells me something, I'll be like, I'm not going to listen to you, right? But then the thing is, we are people who live on social media, right? We've had social media since the age of when we were 16 and 17. And we understand the intricacies of it slightly better. Like this is an argument that I constantly have with my parents. Okay, I'll start off with this one basic incident that happened. Okay, what happened was very recently we have this family WhatsApp group, right? I'm sure all of you are on a family WhatsApp group. Yes, where everyone sends 30 good morning messages with flowers and kids on it. Yes, very nice. Mr. Sundaram is laughing. Are you the one who's sending those messages in the group? Yes, probably, because that smile gives it up. Right. So we are on this group, and very recently what happened is my uncle, he posted a message on that group, right? He posted a link on that group, and he was like, if you share this link with 20 more people, everyone will get 20,000 rupees each. Okay. Now this to any logical person will seem wrong, right? Why is anyone giving us 20,000 rupees for free? Right. It is not going to happen. But what everyone in the group did, all my relatives, including my parents, they all clicked on that link, because I don't know why they want 20,000. They wanted 20,000. They all clicked on that link, and now each of them lost 1500 rupees each from their account, right? And now there is no claim. There is no trace to it, right? So this is the first basic point of it. If someone is giving you unnecessary money, do not trust it. Because the social media is like the real world. No one will give you money for free. Okay, so be very careful. This especially happens in these groups where I notice where all of these people are just, you know, trying to make money out of these suspicious links. So never trust those links. That is point one that I'd really like to tell you guys. Secondly, there is a lot of misinformation on social media these days, right? Our first speaker, Mr. Ravi Kumar, has covered it on how misinformation is spread across social media. but I would like to give you a very nice example of how it works. It is, how many of you are from Hyderabad over here or have been to Hyderabad or know the Hyderabad culture? Great, great. Okay, a lot of you. Great, nice. So for those of you who do not know Hyderabad, हमको ना लंबी लंबी फेंकने की आदत है इन हैदराबाद लाइक वी लाइक के ट्रेन लेट्स से इफ यू आर लाइक ये 5 मिनट लेट हुआ तो वी लाइक ओ परसों से नहीं आया यू नो दैट इज जस्ट हाउ वी आर दैट इज आवर इंस्टिंक्ट राइट एंड देयर इज अ वेरी नाइस गेम दैट वी यूज्ड टू प्ले इन स्कूल दिस इज कॉल्ड चाइनीज विस्पर्स राइट सो व्हाट हैपेंस इन दिस इज यू हैव टू टेल अ मैसेज इन योर नेक्स्ट पर्सनस ईयर Right, and he has to tell the message further, and he has to tell the message further. And by the time the message reaches the 10th person, the complete meaning itself has changed. Right, and this is how social media is also operating. Right, for example, the first story that appears on social media, right, the initial story that appears on social media would be, okay, let's say, I'll talk about Shakil sir, because Shakil sir I know personally and I know he cannot get angry at me. Okay, so I'll take Shakil sir as an example. Okay, so let's assume the first story is that a cat came to Shakil sir's house and it stole the milk and it went. It drank the milk and it went. Billi Shakil sir ke ghar pe aake doodh peeke chale gaye. Okay, by the time this news reaches the third person, the news would have changed on social media. Because that's how social media works. By the time it reaches the third person, the news is Billi Shakil sir ka doodh peeke chale gaye. Theek hai? And by the time this news reaches the 10th person, the entire thing is ki Hyderabad mein doodh ich khatam ho gaya, Billi aap pura doodh chori kar liye. Right? And this is how news is amplified on social media. This is very true. Because as you know, you all are PR professionals. You all know how much a journalist needs to fact check before putting a news in a newspaper, right? Because of social media, that barrier has gone away. You can post anything, it can get shared and it can appear as true. For example, one mistake that we make is we assume that if anything is written on a square photo like this, it must be true, right? Any square, agar koi photo pe text dal diya, to it must be true, right? We have to stop assuming that. We have to stop sharing such things because it is a matter of 1 second. There is a very simple app where you can take the text, you can put it on a photo, and it becomes real. So do not trust. My first point is please do not trust such information. Do not share such information. And I'm sure I do not need to tell you guys what misinformation can do, because in PR, you handle misinformation. A lot of journalists, I myself, when I was working with the Times of India, Shakil sir will not tell you. Shakil sir, when I was working in Times of India, he sent me a rejoinder. Okay, how could you write like this, right? But there are no rejoinders for social media. There are no rejoinders for Facebook. Right, and that we need to understand ourselves before we share information like this. The second point that I think is really important is that on social media, if you see, it affects our mental health a lot if you're spending a lot of time on social media. Because every time you're on social media, you're thinking, this person's life is great. Iska to achcha chal raha hai. And you log into social media, people are just happy over there, right? Someone's bought a new car, someone's bought a new home, someone's having a very pretty, beautiful kid, someone's kid is going to Oxford and whatnot. And you start feeling a little bad. Okay, why is my life not this great, right? This happens, this tends to happen because this is how social media is created. Now, at this point, we need to understand that anything that we post on social media is posted by us, right? We are the ones posting it. Now, if something bad is happening with me, why will I post it? Right. And that goes the same for everyone who's posting on social media. There is a lot of bad things that are happening in their life also, but they'll post only the good things. And what happens is you look at your bad things, you go on social media and you see everyone else is just happy and you start feeling bad. So that's the thing. Keep this in mind. It's not, they're just not posting their bad stuff. Do not take it to heart. Social media is a really fake world. Okay, we need to acknowledge that first of all. I'm sure all our speakers will agree to this, that this is a menace that we need to, we should treat it like a game. Social media is a game. Like all the big influencers who are there in the social media market, it's called the social media game, right? And it's called a game for this reason because we are not supposed to personally invest in it. Like if I can take you back to what our previous speaker said also, he said, do not invest personally, do not give your personal email IDs, do not give your personal numbers, because this is not a real world, right? And we need to keep it like that. Of course, we should not be spreading fake news because we are not Salim Fekho, guys. We have to keep it very clear. Now, these are the serious things these are serious thoughts that had come to me. Now you must be wondering, ek aisa stand-up comedian hai jo abhi tak ek baar bhi nahi hasaya, hai na, mere ko to bilkul hansi nahi aaye. So I'll tell you jokes also. Mere paas jokes bhi hai. Theek hai. But there is one prerequisite before I tell the jokes. Okay, you people cannot be sitting like this. Ke tu hasa ke dikha. Okay, I cannot make you laugh. If you're sitting like this and judging me, how will I make you laugh? Right, like Mr. Ravindran sir, I am looking at you right now. You are judging me a lot, okay? And this is not acceptable. This will not work. Okay, very nice. Ashish Dayal ji has started his video. Very good. He is. I know you're here for jokes. Cool. Let's try and do some.
That's great.
So you know what happened? What happened recently is that I left my family WhatsApp group. I did this very big thing of leaving my family WhatsApp group. And my parents take my family WhatsApp group so seriously, they are behaving like I left the family. You know, like my mom is like, how could you do something like this? We are all over here. How can you leave the family? I'm like, I just left the group. They're like, no, you're not allowed to leave the family. And that is when I started thinking, because now when I look at my parents, I'm talking to you guys right now over here. I go outside. My parents, they are constantly on their phone. You know, 24 hours, they're either sharing something, they're either telling something, they're either video calling their friends. And it is so funny because 3 years back, they were lecturing me ki tum phone pe bahut zyada time spend karte ho. And now life has come a full circle because now I go and tell them ki aap phone pe bahut zyada time spend kar rahe. You know, there is no moral high ground left with them. But Hyderabad is a really funny place in such ways. One of the nicest things about, SMS that is gone due to WhatsApp. Now we have all these videos that we can send on WhatsApp. Now we have all these, messages and funny things that we send. Before WhatsApp, we had this lovely thing called SMS, right? And I really miss SMSs a lot because we used to get nice forward messages, which were jokes. And does any of you remember a joke that you've heard or that you've read on an SMS? No? You must, but you're like, I cannot tell it here. This is an official meeting. I get it. It's okay. So my favorite Hyderabadi message that I had read on the SMS was two kids are there. Okay, two bachche rehte. Everyone's comfortable with Hindi, I hope.
Yes.
Right. Okay, great. So Hyderabadi Hindi mein hai joke, to main Hyderabadi Hindi mein sunata hu. Okay. So joke aisa hai ki two bachche rehte. Okay. So ek bachcha jo hai, wo dusre ko bolta ki हमारे बाबा जो है हमारे बाबा इतने लंबे हैं, हमारे बाबा इतने लंबे हैं, खड़े खड़े पंखे को रोक देते, राइट? एंड दूसरा बच्चा जो है, ही लुक्स एट हिम एंड ही गोस, हमारे बाबा भी उतने लंबे ही हैं, पर तुम्हारे बाबा जैसे हौले कामा नहीं करते, राइट? बिकॉज दिस इज हाउ वी हैदराबादी आर, राइट? एंड द फर्स्ट पर्सन दैट यू लिसन टू विद दिस मैसेज कि हमारे बाबा इतने लंबे हैं, इतने लंबे हैं, दिस इज व्हाट एवरी न्यूज चैनल इज राइट नाउ. Okay, they will take a small issue and like, "Hamare baba itne lambe hai, itne lambe." So we need to keep this in mind while watching any news channel right now. The other thing, this is a very funny incident. I was working as a radio jockey with Radio Mirchi, right? And at that time, people think it's a very glamorous job. A lot of people know you, but the truth is, only cab drivers know me. Okay, like it is a thing. They know me, like they know everything that I say. So once I was in this cab. And this cab driver like, "Saab, main aapko ek baat bolta hu, aap ye sabko bol dena." Okay. And since that day, I'm telling it to everyone because he said a very funny thing. And we're like, "Ye Hyderabad jo hamara shahar hai na, ye bahut bahut ajeeb hai saab." Bola, "Kyun aisa kyun bol rahe ho aap?" Kehta, "Hamare shahar mein kya kiya na, jitni bhi patli galiyan hai na, wo pure Hyderabad mein daal diye. Jitni bhi bade bade roada hai na, wo pure jo hai na, wo leke Cyberabad mein daal diye. और ये शहर के पूरे तीनों के मिला के जितने भी स्पीड ब्रेकर आए ना, वो पूरे के पूरे सिकंदराबाद में डाल दिए, राइट? एंड आई जेन्युइनली बिलीव दिस इज ट्रू एंड द पीपल हु आर लाफिंग हियर, आई नो आप लोग सिकंदराबाद में रहते हैं एंड यू आर हैप्पी दैट द लॉकडाउन इज हियर, क्योंकि आपको ऐसे 10 बार ऐसे ऐसे होके ऑफिस नहीं जाना पड़ रहा है, राइट? देयर इज दिस जॉय इन इट. व्हाट एल्स? सो आई हैव टू टिप्स दैट आई हैव प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर यू, राइट? एज एन एविड सोशल मीडिया influencer, if you can say, because my earnings are driven by social media. It's a very new concept. I get paid per post, right? And my parents are not happy about it at all because they wanted me to have a stable government job, and I'm doing the exact opposite of that, right? But there are few things that I've learned from this, three basic things. The first thing is ke, do not check social media as soon as you wake up. Nothing good will come out of it. We have this habit na, uthte hi apna phone dekhne ke kya chal raha hai, kyun? Because as I said earlier, wahan sab khush hai. Everyone over there is happy. You will just feel bad about yourself. And you do not want to be starting your day like that. Correct? So as soon as you wake up, do not touch your phone at least for 2 hours. Even if you're touching your phone, do not open Facebook or Instagram. I know it is tempting. I know Facebook ka F bulata hai ki aajao, aajao. Dekh lo kya hai. Do not do it. Okay? The second tip that I would like to share with you guys is ke everyone is happy. You can also be happy if you're off social media. Do take social media detoxes. Do not check it every day. The likes on social media mean nothing. Okay, of course, they mean something. But do not take it personally. You know, ki mereko to sirf do hi like hai, usko 15 like hai. Dekho, life mein compare karne ke liye, we have so many things. Why to add one more and feel bad about it, right? So likes mean nothing. Just go there and just share what you like. And do not expect people to respond to it, because that shouldn't bother us. And the third and the most important thing, which is very important in our society these days, is we all need to learn how to scroll. ये चीज़ हम भूल चुके हैं. Because what happens is we are scrolling, right? We are scrolling. फिर हमको दिखता है कुछ जिससे हमको बहुत गुस्सा आता है. And then we stop scrolling. And then we are like, तू ऐसा क्यों बोला? तू ऐसा क्यों बोला? इसका क्या मतलब है? ये ऐसे क्यों है? ये वैसे क्यों? ये वैसे क्यों? And now, for all you know, तुम्हारा 3 घंटे के लिए मूड खराब है. Right? Your juniors in the office are not understanding कि सर आज गुस्से में क्यों है. है ना, बच्चों को समझ नहीं आ रही है क्यों हो रहा है. बट दैट इज प्रॉब्ली बिकॉज ऑफ अ सोशल मीडिया पोस्ट, राइट? सो नेक्स्ट टाइम व्हेन यू सी अ पोस्ट दैट मेक्स यू एंग्री, जस्ट रिमेंबर वन सिंपल फॉर्मूला. टेक अ डीप ब्रेथ, स्क्रोल. क्लियर? व्हाट इज द फंडा? टेक अ डीप ब्रेथ, स्क्रोल. ग्रेट? फॉलोड? ऑलराइट. सो विद दैट नोट, लेट्स मेक आवर इंटरनेट अ बेटर प्लेस. एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर हैविंग मी हियर. बैक टू शकील.
थैंक यू भवनी, थैंक्स अ लॉट. ये देखो यार, बेसिकली क्या है, हर चीज़ की जो है एक टॉपिंग होती है, जो आइसिंग इन द केक बोलते हैं ना, वो है. और आई नो प्रिटी वेल के जो है तुमने सिर्फ थोड़ा ही जो है अपना एक व्यू पॉइंट शेयर किया है, बट मज़ा आ गया. और इनपुट्स एक देखिए, सोशल मीडिया वगैरह से रिलेटेड जो है हर चीज़ पीआर प्रैक्टिशनर्स के लिए इंपॉर्टेंट है. सब में अहम चीज़ जो आपने बोला है शायद हमारे लिए जो है काफ़ी अहम है, ये कि जो है सुबह पहली चीज़ जो है अपने सोशल मीडिया को जो है देखने वाली नहीं होना चाहिए. आई थिंक प्रॉब्ली दैट्स अ वेरी गुड टेक अवे फ्रॉम द एंटायर थिंग. Thanks a lot, Bhavneet, once again.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, now is the time, sir, you know, for the most eminent of the speakers, Jairam ji, sir, to please address the audience. Jairam ji, sir, please.
Having heard beautiful speakers, I don't think there is a need for talking on communication or anything. But again, I'll since you have requested me, I want to say a few words. My mind goes only with the PR, CI and PR, our YCC, WCC and our members. Of course, public relations in India, a country described by many as the largest democratic country in the world, is to examine from the historical and social perspective rather than what is happening in other countries. PR is emerging a key strategic and operational discipline to meet global communication and marketing environment. Over a period of 40 plus years, if I'm right, public relations, PR, in fact, in India, had witnessed a sea change both in quantity and its quality. Though PR profession is growing in India, with the increasing number of in-house public relations, PR firms, there is a dearth of training. This is what we have noticed in our PRCI. Qualified, competent PR professionals who can handle the even increasing corporate communication programs, strategic things are lacking. The lack of proper education, training, textbooks, students, professionals, and corporates depending upon foreign textbooks, etc., etc. This has to go. That's why we thought that there are so many what is called PR firms, more than 1,000 PR firms during when we started PRCI. were there, PR societies and PR circles, even then, there was some problem we faced. That's what we thought during 2004. And we have decided to start a separate body for professionals in the year 2004, April 3rd, if I'm right. The objective of any institution is to systematically analyze the relevant knowledge in its domain and codify it for easy understanding and dissemination among the practitioners of a particular discipline. Corporates, students, Public Relations Council started on this basis and a handful of professionals during that time. Today, it has spread all over the country, and we have glad to tell you that we have 38 chapters and four chapters outside the country in the banner of WCC. And we are a non-political organization. We think of only the members and their benefits and the ever increasing our importance of communication extended its being in many fields and required connectivity that brings in the coherence among the various units of management, different publics of the companies, internal and external rings of activities. In other words, it brings in a sense that oneness of the purpose and directions we have started. So many activities inside the PRCA that is that may be guest expert poll or internship facilities for students or maybe a training program for many. There is a separate requirement. There are many people are asking us to start diploma, 11 months diploma or certificate course through PRCA. All these are coming out to promote our own people, PR fraternity, where every year we experience and super performing PR industry professionals are working, striving hard to make it happen. This is why we are taking this. We have taken a cursory look at the history of PR and PRC and the development since a long time. Now, let us consider the fact that PRC in India has to be genuinely interested in promoting the professional values, aims to bring together all communication professionals on the global platform, share ideas and exchange experience for overall progress of the humanity. Our vision under PRC is to be the one-stop knowledge center in the field of mass communication with the motto of communication for a better world. This is what I can say at the moment. And only we don't believe in just talking. Practically, we do it. All our office bearers like Vinay Kumar, Geeta Shankar, or Suklaji, or TVS Narayan, or whoever are here, and Anindita Ji, and Ravindran, and many more, Ashish, Ramendra from Roorkela, and Kolkata, Mr. Sahu, everyone is striving hard to the success of our own fraternity. And definitely, in a matter of some time, we'll become number one in India. Maybe we'll extend our as for the betterment of our own profession and the fraternity. This is all I can tell you immediately. And then later, all the webinars which we are going to have in a few months by now, you will hear a lot of plus point from PRCA. And tomorrow also there is a webinar from YCC Bangalore chapter, and 27th again on traveling world traveling day is there. And again, there are so many webinars coming up from all our chapters. Kindly attend all the chapter webinars. That is my sincere request to you all people, and support our own PR professionals by doing this. Thank you so much for giving me an opportunity to talk, because I was not prepared for this immediately when you asked, I thought, let me tell only this much. Thank you so much, Mr. Shakil, for allowing me to speak a few words on PRCI. Thank you so much.
Sir, I am indebted to you, sir. Thanks a lot for the impromptu address, sir. And let me tell you, sir, PRCI, not in terms of quantity, but in terms of quality, is already the number one in India.
And thank you, sir.
With you being the flagship, we all are dedicated and committed to carry the baton forward. Thanks a lot, sir.
Now, we are equal. We are equal always. I am maybe the first among the equals. I always believe first, teamwork.
Sir, being first amongst the equal matters, sir, that actually acts as the impulse to us. Thanks a lot, sir. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Sir, now I leave the stage, you know, to the entire, you know, audience, which is quite experienced. You know, if I take names, probably it is a long list because every one of them, you know, holds a lot of caliber. I request the audience to please join in and share their viewpoints. Any one of them, you know, can come in.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Well, this is Ashok Panda from Bhubaneswar.
Namaskar, sir. Thanks, sir.
Namaskar. Yeah, sir. Right. Thank you so much. Actually, you see,
he's the chairman of Bhubaneswar chapter.
Yeah, excellent, thank you.
Sir. Excellent.
Thank you. You see, what a very simple question I have for you, the panel members who are interested to speak. The question is very, very simple. You see, public relations is negotiating changes with minimum friction. We have heard all our life that public relations is negotiating changes with minimum friction. But now I find public relation is becoming changes with maximum friction. What do you think? We need to redefine public relations, the definition of public relations? Any panel members who would love to answer this? Earlier, you know, it was least friction. Now, you know, a lot of friction has come, and that too, you know, with social media and many other factors. Now, who would be answering this question?
Mr. Bhavneet?
So from my understanding of the subject, as you said before, it was to create the least friction, right? But that was at a time where only two mediums existed. One was the person who was telling the news, the other who was publishing the news. Now, because of social media, everyone has the power to publish anything that can go viral. Right. And so my understanding of the topic is that it has become friction minimizing activity. It's become a friction minimizing activity because no matter what you put out, there will always be some people, there'll always be enough fake accounts who will spread fake news or misinformation or a bad feeling about it. So I think our job is to minimize it as much as possible right now.
Okay. Under the circumstances, we need to minimize it, even though, you know, it moves up. Thank you. Well, thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else, please? Ma'am, Michael, sir, have you got something to share? My friend, Ravindran.
Unmute,
sir.
Unmute.
My friends.
Mr. Sundaram wants to say something.
Yes, sir, please.
I just want to talk about an experience that I had in the early 70s.
Yes, sir.
When I was working with the Indian Space Research Organization, I was in the public relations department there.
Yes, sir.
And 1975, the first satellite Aryabhata was launched.
Yes, sir.
1976, we were having an exhibition in Chennai. Yes, and sir. I was briefing the journalists. It was just before the inauguration of the exhibition. The previous day, I was just briefing them. And one of the one journalist from a very important news agency, even today it is existing, he asked me a question: what will happen to Aryabhata? So I said, Aryabhata will have to, any satellite that is put in the orbit will have to come down one day after its life is over. But the next day, the moment I reached Bangalore, in the morning, I find everyone is carrying a newspaper with them. I asked, what is the news? He said, yeah, what you have said. I said, what I have said? He said, Aryabhata may come down. This is the heading. And so-and-so said, so-and-so added, so-and-so I was really shocked because I said, I made a statement which is a real a truth of the fact. But this person has, coined it in such a way, and the headline was given as Aryabhatta may come down. That went throughout the world because it was important news agency. Yes, and yes. I was in a fix. I did not know what to say. And then Professor U.R. Rao was the head of that department in ISRO Satellite Center. He called me. He said, what the hell have you said? I said, I don't know. I mean, I made a statement that anything, because with my knowledge and with the, it is a truth also, fact. But he has just combined it like this. And then it went up to the chairman. Professor Satish Dhawan was the chairman at that time. Then he said, there's nothing. Don't worry, Mr. Pillai. This happens. Because what you said is right. But the way that the journalist has coined it and then put it to sensationalize the information, he has done it, so you don't worry about it. Then only I was satisfied.
Mm-hmm.
So this
I think that was good.
This kind of thing to happen.
Yeah, right.
Even though as a PR person, you did the right thing. I mean, sincerely, you told the journalist what will happen. I mean, you explained to him. But he said that the satellite may go berserk, this thing. Yes. And because the satellite was just launched 1 year before that. And yes. It was a new thing to India, as far as India was concerned. Aryabhatta was the first satellite to be launched.
Sir, Junalakadda Lakshmikant sir is on. He raised his hand.
Yes, please.
Yeah, I just wanted to point out, I think Bhavneet and the previous speaker both mentioned the right points. So I think there are three things that we need to consider. Sanctity of the message, whatever message is being put out, and the sensitivities of the people involved. And then the third one, obviously, is which is actually gaining more ground than these two, sensation. So I think, the social media is giving more importance to sensation than the sanctity of the message and the sensitivities of the people involved. And that is why, the earlier question came in. So if the journalists or people who are putting out the messages or retweeting or resharing, if only they can look at the sanctity of the message and the sensitivities of the people involved and the people that are going to be exposed to this message, if they can pay attention to this rather than sensationalizing the message, I think we'll be back on the right track.
Yes, sir. Thank you. I would to add to it, what I can say is for us PR professionals, the right jargon now is say no to three yes. Okay, say no to three yeses.
Well, Michael Saab. Yes, with the old age adage that PR practitioners were spin doctors, in the present day circumstances with the social media and technology gaining importance, everybody is newsmaker. It is not only with the journalists. Of late, we have seen in the news how several information that is being widely spread on the social media. How could then the PR practitioners adapt from the spin doctors and make the point of their point of view more credible?
Very valid point, sir. Very valid point. Excellent. You're right.
Yeah, the earlier speaker was Mr. Pillai. He is a proposed chapter of Trivandrum. It's proposed the chairman also. I think Vinay Kumar will tell you all these new chapters later.
Yes, sir.
And the dates of webinars for everyone. Kindly, because this is needed to support all chapters. And
yes,
there are few people I saw. Mr. R.T. Kumar, one of the founder director of Governing Council, he is also there with us. And Mr. Kaul, director from Delhi, is one of the former first member of the PRCI. All Beeta from Bangalore, they're all, they attend almost all the webinars. That kind of interest one should have. That's what I feel, including particularly in Hyderabad. I found a lot of enthusiasm members are there. Thanks to Michael and Anindita and Philip and others. To within a span of 2 months, they have collected a lot of PR professionals. That's a great thing. I must appreciate them wherever they are. That is the team spirit, you know.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
I want this kind of, even Shakil also, and one must, Mr. Narayan and Mr. Albert, all these people to be remembered on this occasion. I need the, all other chapters also follow the same food of Hyderabad chapter. Then there is no problem for PR stay to go further. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir.
I would invite Mr. Philip Joshua, my good friend, secretary for PRCA, to share a few words. PRCA, the silent warrior.
Thank you, sir. It has been a very good experience. About, you know, miscommunication, I do want to tell a small anecdote of half a minute. Pope, one of the popes, you know, he visited Belgium. He visited Belgium, and that country was, you know, famous for prostitution and all. So the Pope, by chance, he asked, you know, how is prostitution? Is it still active, you know, or what is the news? So the next day, the headlines in the paper was, Pope inquires about prostitution. Thank you. That's
here,
it. So we need to be careful what we tell.
No, over here, Philip, how we tell it. That's it. Yes. Over here, Phyllis, I got something to say about, you know, an autocorrect also. There was sort of a banner which says shoplifters will be prosecuted. Unfortunately, the autocorrect had something else to say. It said shoplifters will be prostituted.
Prostituted, exactly.
That is how dangerous it can be.
Yeah. So very good. Thank you. Enjoyed the session, sir. It was short and sweet.
Yes, yes, sir. And I would now request the dynamic chairperson, Hyderabad chapter, Anandita ji, to please come on and present the word of thanks. Anandita, please.
Hi, good evening.
Anandita, sorry, I forgot one thing. All webinars are now under scrutiny, and we have decided to award all these webinars which has taken place from the last 6 months. Our judges, including Vinay Kumar, they are watching all the webinars. I'm sure that you are one among them who is competing with the other chapters. All the best.
Yeah, very great initiative from PRCA, sir.
Thank you so much. Since you have told me that for the next webinars, I'll apply good makeover, makeup.
Yes, yes. I understand.
When you know, I'm a very ardent IPL fan, and when Dhoni is in front of me somewhere winning the toss for today's IPL, I think I'll cut short and release everyone to enjoy the IPL, the starting of the match today. But I mean, it was a brilliant topic, nice discussion, and thanks to Shakil ji, it was of course his idea. Yes. You know, he had a lot of problems with him, but he said, I have committed to you, so I will do it, and I'm so thankful for that. I know I should come, it should cascade down, but I should start with Shakil ji. Shakil ji, thank you so much for organizing this webinar. Now, coming to our guest speakers, thank you so much, everyone. Mr. Ravi Kumar, Mr. Lakshmikant, Mr. Hari Krishna, Dynamic and Bhavneet. Yes, I know you all fact correction properly, but what happens, it goes to the desk and the headlines get completely changed and sensationalized. Right? So fact corrections are there, but then at times it goes wrong. Many people, they don't have the habit of reading the entire news, and they make an opinion just reading the headlines. But I really agree with whatever you said. And especially I identify you with my two grown-up sons who I have back home almost your age. So I understand. But there are so learned speakers. So much we learn from Ethical Hacking. Mr. Lakshmikant, such a beautiful perspective. Mr. Ravi Kumar. I mean, you know, I think I am too less learned in the topic to even go into further detail in whatever they said. But then, yes, I feel that... you know, we cannot do without technology. Let us accept the fact. And in fact, this COVID-19 has proved it, that we cannot do with it. And I feel, and rightly, as Bhavneet says, it goes as a Chinese whisper. And it already, you know, I thought of speaking on this. I will not elaborate since he has already spoken on it. But what happens is that I think tech does not go wrong in communication. We take you know, we take the wrong path. We use technology in the wrong way for miscommunication. That is where things go wrong. Now, what you see, technology, when we say, of course, it is little, I will little move away, but think about the OTT platforms. Now, since this COVID has brought everything, all this home TVs together. Now, we had, film is a mode of very popular communication, right? Now, there is a, you know, your, what do you say, censor board and everything who controls communication. What happens when it comes to the Netflixes and Amazon Primes and all the other OTT channels? You have absolutely no control on it. I mean, I think somewhere, as I think one of our speakers rightly pointed out that government intervention, I think Mr. Ravi Kumar pointed out that government intervention should be there. And as you have, you should have on this social media also, all these platforms also. Because see, we are sending a message which is being eaten and accepted by the society. How many people have the prudence to even do an analytical judgment over it? No, not many people. So there is something we really need to. Now, fake news, yes. Now, what happens is, for suppose for an organization or a corporate, where suppose like a corporate where I work in, now before the fake news goes around, communicate what you have to say. So once a formal official communication goes, then the chance of fake news being circulated goes very less. So again, you know, we take so much time in, you know, God forbid if any adverse situation, we take so much time in communicating and telling the world what the facts are and the figures are. So the news starts spreading. And just like as Bhavani says, Chinese whispers. Another thing while communicating, we should always keep in mind is keeping the emotional under control, our emotions under control. So when we write, you know, at times we are in the fairy tale world. Okay, and especially if you are having in the evening relax after taking, you know, coming back from office and having a drink in hand, we are in a different world altogether. So there we don't keep the emotions in control. And that is one, in fact, the survey says that as per the day, you know, as the days go, you know, you change your behavioral pattern in communication also. Like when you're in a serious official mood, you're very alert. When you're at home, you're much relaxed. So, you know, these also can take a very take your communication to a very wrong path. So we have to intelligently use technology. Technology will always be there, always prosper. It that is the future. We cannot do without it. Okay, so as we are talking about progress and development, and especially as we are talking here, it is through a you know, webinar, Zoom channel, a tech medium. Okay, so if we have to use it very, very intelligently. Now, being digitally connected mostly, of course, you know, it has been observed that where it is going wrong at times is the personal touch. Many speakers have spoken about it. Now, digitally connected, what happens is, you know, earlier we never had this. So our body language, we used to be prepared, eye to eye contact. So when the, especially I'm talking this about the future generation, when they go and face an interview board or anyone, any social, anywhere, you will see a lack in confidence in their body language, physical, I mean, whether it's eye contact or the way they use, the way they talk, you will find this difference because they're more and more glued to the digital media and connecting through the digital media, where they don't see a person, where they don't see the reaction of that person in front of them one on one. So that is something also we have, you know, seen. But see, virtual meetings are more successful than, of course, physical meetings in today's date. But then again, when things normalize, again, we have to go back to our, you know, to create a balance. Now it is more lopsided, more of virtual. Of course, virtual closeness is the key of the, you know, is the key thing of the hour. So one has to have complete control on this new age media. Now we have seen on Facebook, as Bhavneet also pointed out, that checking in there, drinking coffee, standing there, hanging upside down. I don't know what this young generation, they want to prove by saying all that. What is happening is they, and you know, the cyber crimes. One of the reasons is you are declaring your location, you what you're doing, and there has been some thefts. I'm sure, you know, people, my learned panelists from the cyber control department, or even, you know, we have learned how ethical hacking happens, they will say, so we are declaring ourselves, we are announcing, we are going public. So nothing, if you see, very little is of our private life. So we have to again think very prudently how much to put in. Put in something which can be of some value add to someone, except, you know, unnecessary, just nonsensical posts or, you know, those communication. More of personal touch is very, very much required, especially with the young generations today. And it is for us to guide them in maybe their way. If we put everything in our way, it will not work. So having said that, thank you so much. Brilliant panel. Our respected, I mean, you know, the YCC, if anyone wants to, can be the symbol, it is our chairman emeritus, Mr. Jaiwal, the youngest in the PRCI and YCC crowd, I think. You know, he thinks very young. That is what youth is all about, thinking young, thinking new. So thank you, sir, so much. Dr. Vinay Kumar is there. National Council heads, Mr. Ravindran, I can see, everyone who I'm not seeing on the screen, from the chapter chairs, Ashish ji is there, Sundaram ji is there, Mr. Panda was there beautifully. He pointed out something fiction. Maybe, Mr. Panda, we can have a webinar topic on that, you know, more of fiction. And all the chapter heads, and coming back to my brilliant, brilliant Hyderabad team, yes, you are very much right, sir. Frederick is the person, you can get, I think Frederick can make a yellow page, you know, the way he's getting the members. He can actually make a yellow page and a journal, and people can, we can sell it to the other chapters and other organizations. And everyone, Jacob, Mr. Anija is there, Mr. Philip is there, everyone at Hyderabad chapter, thank you so much. Thank you so much for being there and doing this fabulous job of Hyderabad chapter. Hyderabad chapter, hip hip hooray.
Thank you. Yeah, thanks a lot, Anandita.
Before you close, I'll tell you, if everything goes right, everything, you know, COVID problems are over, we wanted to have our 15th global meet either in Goa or Mangalore. We are thinking about that. A lot of surprises are waiting for Hyderabad chapter. Maybe Michael, wait for that.
Thank you so much. I have, in fact, when you posted in the group the other day, I've already started my packing my bag. COVID or not COVID, I am coming for sure.
Yeah.
Anandita, with whatever you have shared, I think I committed a mistake, you know, by picking you up as, you know, the person for vote of thanks. You have been one of the brilliant speakers, you know, speaking on the subject. Thanks a lot once again.
No, thank you so much. Thanks, everyone. Have a good day. Enjoy IPL.